to release. Today we'll be using two spiky balls, and hopefully my nervousness will flow out with the stress release with the balls. So if you can find two the same size, or one will be fine. If you don't have spiky balls, then tennis balls or squash balls, and that will be great to get you started. So first up, we'll sit and bring a little bit of mindfulness into our workout. And if you'd like to, you can close your eyes. You can sit with your legs crossed or out in front. So first, if you prefer, you can close your eyes. Focus on the breath. Take some slow, deep breaths in. And you can exhale through the mouth. Going to do the front of the shoulders now, so just in here, try and always work in the soft parts of the body and not on the bony parts, so in between the top of your shoulder and the top of your arm. And again, you can use one ball and remember to swap sides, or you can use both the balls. A little bit tricky to find the right spot, so wriggle around and then from here you can roll out and in. So I'm just sitting up to show you where you can go with this one. Or if you're not comfortable lying down, you can do it sitting up and use the pressure from your hand to roll across the shoulder. So relaxing through the arm, so you can roll out
quite tight in this area, rotator cuff area. Okay, we're doing one side at a time. Swapping over now, we'll spend another half a minute or so here. Focus on what you're feeling. Feeling very uncomfortable. Focus on the breath. Maybe count your breaths to 10. Okay, just bring it up here. You can keep releasing in that spot if you like, and catch us up when you're ready. We're going to do a tricep release now. It can be quite intense, so take your time. We're going to do one arm at a time, or you can do both if you like. So let's get onto the front. So stretching out one arm in front. If you're really keen, you can do both together and just let your arms stretch out in front. It might be easier to do one. So from here, you can roll up and down the tricep. If you don't want to roll, you can find just one spot. And if you're really keen to get a little deeper, you can add a bicep curl. You can hold the bicep curl and roll. Maybe heading down towards the elbow. Get quite sore in there, depending on which type of tricep exercises you've been doing. And swapping to the other side. So adding your bicep curl here. And remember to smile through the intensity. And keep it going. So you can roll or just stay still. Manually move the ball to a different spot if you find rolling too intense for you. Take a break at any time. Okay, let's head on over to the back. So quite a few options here. Or we're going to start right between the shoulder blades. I'll turn around, I'll show you where we're going. Right between the shoulder blades, there's a small gap between your spine and your shoulder blades. So right in the middle, opposite your chest, and we'll head down to the floor. So take your time, get yourself in the right spot before you start moving. Bend your knees now, bring your feet to flat. Focus on your core muscles now, level up your hips across the front. Pressing your lower back into the floor and very slowly start to put your head back towards the floor. Bring your arms by your side, arms facing up. And as you feel yourself starting to relax and sink onto the balls, maybe take some deep breaths now. If this is your problem area, take your time. Welcome to close your eyes, focus on the breath, big deep breath in, and exhale. Let the body weight sink onto the ball. Shuffle around if you don't feel like you're in quite the right spot. Now your options are to stay just here as still as you can, letting the front of your shoulders relax. The belly button drawn in, into the chest. And if you feel like you're ready to move on, you're going to breathe in as you raise your arms and take them over your head as far as they'll go. You don't have to go all the way. And then slowly bring the arms back. Start to move now, folks. If you need to rest at any time, you can bring your arms back to the floor and or take the palms out. After your last one, bring your arms to the floor, relax the front and shoulders. We're going to head down the back now, just for a little release at the bottom of the shoulder blades. Carefully lifting the head up, roll yourself. I'll sit up briefly to show you where we're going with the balls. We're right at the bottom of the shoulder blades now. Just right down here. And before you get comfortable, I'll show you what we're going to do with the arms. We're going to bring them out next to the head like a pitchfork shape here. So the back of your arms will be on the floor. And once we start moving, we're going to flip the hands over to the floor. Okay, so if you're not comfortable moving, just stay with the arms over the head. So again, focus on the core muscles, keep that pelvic floor switching on, and bring those hands up. Shuffle around, make sure you're comfortable and in the right spot with the balls before we start moving. And for me, this is a problem area, so I'll be taking my time, feeling relaxed and relaxing through the back. Focus on the breath if you're finding this challenging. Don't quite that spot, you're welcome to stay just on that spot. And again, you can raise the arms. And you can do all of these movements with your hips on the floor. So let's get them down. You need to release the intensity, so up and over, creeping up the spine. Keep those core muscles switching on now. Pelvic floor's gently in, belly button's gently in. That intensity whenever you can. Okay, last set here. And we'll bring those hips to the floor. Just resting for a moment, take two slow deep breaths. And out. One more time. Let's lift that head up very quickly, rolling over to your side. Now, I know for some of you this is not your favourite release at all, so feel free to skip it, but we're going to head down the rib cage now. So finding the very top, just one spiky ball this time, the very top of your rib cage. So we're lying down, stretching that arm out, and find that very soft spot just under the armpit. And you're ready, lying down on your arm, your front hands pushing into the floor if you need to lift some of your body weight. Stack your knees, keep your muscles switched on. So definitely now take some slow deep breaths. From here, if you want to add some intensity, you can straighten out your top leg. And for all the way, take your hand off the floor and reach it up and over. So wherever you're choosing to go with this one, you can stay still. We can start to roll yourself forward towards your chest and then back towards the back of the ribs. If you need some help with that, put your hand back on the floor. So we're rolling forward and back. Welcome to stay still if you need to. Okay, I'll sit up briefly to show you where we're going next. So we're going to follow the line of the rib cage all the way down to the bottom. So there's a small gap between each of your ribs there. So again, you can use either of the three options, legs together, hand on the floor rolling backwards and forwards. We can add any level of intensity as you like. Don't need to spend a long time on each one, so if you're ready to move along, just lift up the ball, find the next gap in the rib cage, and relaxing. Remember, you don't have to roll, you can just stay still. Take a couple of deep breaths, and then move on. Remember to take your time. If you're not comfortable with this exercise, you can rest on the floor or find a different part of the body you'd like to release and then catch us up when we get to the end of the exercise. You're welcome at any time to close your eyes. Just really get that focus in on the body. And I'm sure your mind is not wandering at this point. It's feeling the, really feeling the intensity of this release. Just about to the bottom now. We've got one more to go. Don't go below your bottom rib. Bring yourself up and we'll swap over to the other side. So find the very top of your ribcage, down on your arm, and resting down. Start slowly. You'll feel very different on this other side, so taking your time if you're on your tighter side now. There's no rush. Remember to add that intensity if you can. Straighten out your top leg. And a roll side to side, and you can also take that arm up and over the head. So whenever you're ready, start to move down the rib cage. And remember, you don't need to spend a long time here. Focus on the breath, core muscles switched on. We're nearly at the end, so keep going.
get yourself to the bottom of your rib cage. If your heart rate's coming up, making sure you focus on the breath and you're not holding your breath as you move through the release. Spend a few minutes now relaxing. So closing your eyes now. Feel the air coming in through your nose and out through your mouth. If you'd prefer to have your relaxation time without any sparky balls resting on the body, you're welcome to take them out. Breathing naturally now, let the air flow in and out of the body. Feeling the gravity pressing you into the floor, feeling your legs heavy. Focus on the breath, just for 10 more breaths. And if you feel that you want to, you can let your thoughts start to flow. Resting on any particular thought, just let them flow through the mind. If you find that's a little too distracting for your relaxation, bring yourself back to counting your breaths to 10. Don't forget that if you'd like to, bring the balls up to the back of your head. Start to run along your fingertips now. Wiggle your toes. Then opening up your head, taking the sparky balls out. And let's
hands roll over onto your side and push yourself up to sitting. Legs crossed or out in front. And again, finish with the balls underneath the palms of your hands. Gently roll. Well done, everyone. I hope you enjoyed that release for your upper body. And look out now for our lower body release. Still using the spiky balls or maybe the roller. So stay tuned. Thanks for watching and we'll see you soon.